We go live.
I just gotta, what microphone is this? One?
One.
Just gotta remember to do one.
So you're just doing one and two? Okay.
So it's one and two.
One and two. I love you.
Love you too. Of the mic. I'm going to be sitting somewhere different. That won't fall, will it?
I mean, if it does, it's going to hit me. I'm
pretty sure this is just... I might just have to use my mic.
Just whatever makes you comfortable. Do whatever's gonna make you comfortable. Cause you're about to be, you don't wanna be uncomfortable for an entire hour.
No.
So, you need your mic?
Yeah, give me my mic.
All right.
I mean, really. You ready?
Ready when you are.
My head. Right. I don't think we got the right plug.
We not?
No. Do this, Victor, if he could get me... Well, let me see if this will work. Be asking if he can get me the thing for my headphones.
You are being the biggest dick of the day. Good.
No. Why's my headphones not working?
You want to show the other ones on our own?
What the heck?
The views expressed on this program are not necessarily the views of Lexington Community Radio or its board of directors. The views expressed are solely those of the programmers.
listening to Off the Cuff. Now, here's your host, Adam Banks.
Welcome, everybody, to Off the Cuff. I am Adam Banks coming at you live from Lexington, Kentucky. Thank you for listening to the show, and thank you for tuning in to WLXU 93.9 LPFM Lexington. If this is your first time tuning in, welcome to the hottest talk radio show in Lexington. In addition to listening on the radio, you can check out our Facebook live stream at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks, or if you are out of the Lexington area, you can download the WLXU app on your smartphone device. Amber Turner is in the studio with me as always. Amber, how are you?
Hey, I am always happy on Thursdays.
And it feels good in the studio.
It feels amazing.
It feels good. For like the first time since we started here, I believe the temperature is finally at a comfortable
temp. At a very comfortable temp.
Yeah, usually.
I am very satisfied today.
Yeah, it's just changed the whole mood.
It has.
Despite the technical difficulties. If people could only, we should just have a radio show just on me being frustrated at all the things that go on here with the technical difficulties.
You know, though, after being with you for so long, like, I'm kind of used to it. Like, I'm kind of numb to it. I just sit over here and I'm like, well, if he, like, looks at me very sternly, I'll pay attention. But otherwise, I just let you do your thing.
Well, hello, everybody listening on Facebook Live and in Lexington. And those who are listening to the app, so globally, those who might be in Florida, Cincinnati,
Spokane, Washington.
Do we have listeners from
Spokane? We have a listener from Spokane, Washington.
That's unbelievable. Let me tell you something. If you are listening out of the Lexington area, I want to know about it. So you should give us a call and just say, hey, tell us where you're listening from. If you are out of the Lexington area and you're actually using the app, I want to know. You can call us at 859-721. 5690, that is the studio number. Let me make sure the ringer is up on that. Oh, it is. So, yeah, give us a call if you want to let us know where you're calling from. Amber, a lot has been going on this week. I'm sure you have been bombarded with signs letting you know that back to school is officially underway.
Unfortunately.
I don't know about you, but at my age, I still, around this time in August, and I don't know why. I don't know if it's just because the way my body has been conditioned around this time throughout my life. But this time, I'm always stressed out about going back to school. Back to school.
Well, unfortunately, I'm on the actual side of going back to school. You know, you've got the luxury, and I don't mean like a luxury, but you get to go be an instructor. I actually have to go back and be a student.
Well, okay, those who know me and have listened to the show, you know that I am a college professor full-time. That's what I do. And school starts back for us next week. And it is different. I'm on the other side of the table.
You're on the other side of the glass.
I'm on the other side, yes. I'm not a student, I'm an instructor. And that's really nice. It really is. But nonetheless, I still get that first day of school feeling. And you know what I'm talking about. There's a certain smell in the air in August.
Yeah.
There's a certain feel in the air in August. You can even hear certain sounds this time of year that let you know, hey, school's getting ready to start.
Yep.
So, for all of the children listening, if there are any children listening to Off the Cuff, it's, let me tell you, it's different per grade that you're in. If you're starting grade school, you're pretty excited because you get to go and you see your friends and you pick out that fresh new fit, and you look good, you got those fresh pair of sneakers on.
Yes.
And then there's a different feeling to high school. There's a different feeling to the high school start. You might be a little anxious, you might be a little nervous. So for those who are listening who might be getting ready to start high school, let me just tell you something. Try to go into it with an open mind. Try to go into it knowing that it is what you make out of it. Looking back on it at my age, I look back on my high school experience, wasn't the best, but I would like to almost go back and do it over again just so I can make it better, because I don't feel like I tried to make it. I don't think I embraced high school like I did college.
No, because we weren't, you know, we, in our county, we didn't do grade school, middle school, high school. I think if we would have had that opportunity to have that, you know, that middle ground where we would have came together with people from other elementary schools, it might not have been as bad. But we went straight from being with the same people for, you know, some people for 9 years. You know, I didn't come until second grade, so I was only, you know, with you guys for 7 years. And then all of a sudden, I'm supposed to make friends with all these people. I have no idea who they are.
David on the show thread says he's listening from the UK Student Center. David, appreciate you listening. Those who might be starting college, that's a different feeling as well. Man, that feeling away to college that night before because you know you're going to go, you're going to move into your dorm, you're going to meet all these people, all these new people that are your age. You are never going to have a time, again, where you're surrounded by thousands of people your own age in college.
No. Well, I mean, I feel like there's quite a few of us non-traditional students that I have come in contact with since going back to college.
Yeah.
But no, it's nothing like what it was when, you know, I first started.
Right. Well, back-to-school sales have been put in your face. It's you've been bombarded with it. We went to the mall the other day together.
We did.
We actually went to the mall to do a little shopping. Not school shopping.
No, not school shopping.
But we had to pick up a few things. But yeah, it was very much in our face, back to school. And it just brought back memories, man.
I'm really curious as to what your favorite first day was. Everybody has a favorite, and everybody has their worst. I'm curious as to what your favorite was.
My favorite first day of anything was the first day of senior year of high school.
Okay.
I liked it because I knew it was almost over. I knew I had one more year to go. Oh, and I had a point to tell all the high schoolers that were listening. Just know that life gets better after high school.
And your life as a freshman in high school will not even remotely look similar to your life even as a college freshman and then on, you know, into your 20s. And obviously now I'm into my 30s, into your 30s.
Like, I'm sitting here telling you, if you think that high school is all there is and what seems so important to you in high school, the girl you like, the boy you like, your popularity status, whatever that is at your present moment in high school, just know it is not going to last.
No.
Okay? Do not be one of these people who peak in high school. That's the worst thing I believe in life that could happen.
We've done a whole podcast over peaking in high school.
Yeah, you can check that out in our archives on iTunes. You can go to the archives and listen to the episode we did called Peaking in... Glad I Didn't Peak in High School.
Glad I Didn't Peak in High School.
I believe that's what it's called.
That is what it's called.
But you got to understand that there is a whole big world out there with all kinds of different people all that come from all different walks of life, and life gets better after it.
It does.
It really does.
It really does. And, you know, I will say I'm always fortunate for the time that I had, you know, in elementary school and high school, because there are a few of you guys that I still keep around. You know, you've been in my life for 20 plus years, you know.
Yeah.
So you do make some good friendships, but just because, you know, things don't always look sunny, don't let that, you know, get you down. Oh, I'm never going to have friends. I'm never going to be popular. Do not base any of your life on popularity because, baby, once you're out of high school, it don't matter.
It don't matter. And I wish I could stress that enough because we do. We think that's all there is. We think that life will never get any better and our situation will never get any better. Don't feel bad if you're not the most popular. Don't feel bad if you don't have the girl that you want or the guy that you want.
Don't feel bad if you didn't get the superlative you wanted to get.
Don't feel bad if you are not an athlete and not everybody's going crazy over you because you're an athlete. Because life really begins after high school.
Life really kind of fully begins after college.
Yeah.
Like, because, you know, you've got college and you've got all this transitional state because are you living in the dorm? Are you living in an apartment with somebody? Like, life really gets going. I want to say my life didn't get going until I was about 25.
Kathy Conley on the show thread, she says, what advice can you give me for the upcoming school year? We start next Wednesday. Ms. Conley, you just be yourself, okay? You go in, be your positive, loving self. More teachers need to be like you. Just go out there, care about the students. That's really the advice that I can give you. But I was just speaking personally to the incoming freshmen that might have a little anxiety about trying to be picture perfect in high school. Don't worry about it. And I know I'm that old man that you're hearing, that we all heard growing up saying, oh, it gets better. I know what you're going through. Trust me when I say this. I know what you're going through. I've been there. And it can get a little stressful. But yeah, we went to the mall. I don't go to the mall often.
No, I feel like that was the first time I had been in years. Well, at least a year.
Well, I mean, we live in Lexington, and
that's on the other side of town from us, though.
It's a different place that I don't... It's just a place that I don't really go too much.
No, well, there's, you know, we live in the Hamburg area. Ease of access for us, you know. We've got a lot of the little strip mall out there. There's no sense in going all the way to the mall, but it is fun.
It is.
What was your favorite part?
My favorite part about the mall is probably people watching.
Okay.
I love going.
So it wasn't going to the mall with me?
No.
Oh.
I love people watching.
Okay.
Yeah, I love going and just watching what other people do when they think nobody's looking.
Well, did you see anything interesting?
Did they take Spencer's out of the mall?
Spencer's has been gone, honey, for a while.
That just goes to show you. Yeah.
Wait, did I just lie? Is Spencer's still there?
That's what I was wondering. Is Spencer's even in the Fayette Mall? I haven't seen it.
Where was Spencer's at in the mall? Was it over, like, towards Dick's Sporting Good? If so, I think it's still there. I think I might have just lied, guys. Somebody let us know if Spencer's is still open.
Yeah, is Spencer's still open in the Fayette Mall?
Because if it is, we should go.
I want to go.
We should go.
Because usually that's where I see my interesting things. What was the most interesting, you asked? One of the most interesting things that I seen. Well, for the circumstance of why I was there, I was so tunnel vision focused on the task at hand. I didn't get to do a lot of people watching.
No, we had no time.
I was very stressed.
We had no time.
Yeah. Because I had to pick out the perfect outfit for Midday Kentucky.
He had to pick out his perfect outfit.
Which I was on this past Monday, and I'm going to talk about that after the first commercial break, Amber. So stick around, folks. We got to take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back after these words.
Council's The Prep Academy offers special services for migrant families. The Prep Academy, early childhood excellence.
Bluegrass Cycling Club reminds you Kentucky now has a 3-foot passing law. Motor vehicles must leave at least 3 feet when passing a cyclist on a single lane road, and the driver must change lanes to pass. Kentucky is the 30th state to adopt this safety measure for cyclists. Drive safely, ride safely, and share the road Lexington.
Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Sorry if that busted your eardrums. Music got really loud there.
Well, that's a good song, so it's okay.
The Rolling Stones?
Yeah, that's a good song.
How did the Rolling Stones get their own magazine?
I don't know if it's necessarily their magazine.
It's not theirs?
I don't know. I literally have no knowledge about that whatsoever.
But I always wondered that, because there's the Rolling Stones band, and then there's the Rolling Stones magazine. I'm like, well, what made them the...
I don't think it is.
What made them the go-to band to have a magazine named after them?
I don't know if it's correlated or not.
So it's completely different?
I think it's just completely random oddity.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I was on Midday Kentucky, hosting again, co-hosting with Amber Freeman. I did it on Monday. It's an absolute blast. I love being on there. Hope that you got to tune in. It's on ABC 36 from 12:30 to 1. Amber, did you get a chance to watch?
You know I did, and I feel like every time I see you on the TV, I feel like I understand now why my grandmother used to just go bananas when, like, my letter for, you know, Santa Claus would get read on Channel 26. Because when you love somebody and you see that they're doing something great, like, you just can't help but cry. You were making me laugh the whole time because you were just absolutely hilarious this week. I don't know why. Not that you're not always hilarious. But this week, you were just more. I really felt like you were being yourself. Like, I felt like, okay, that's the Adam I know. But, man, you know, for every time I laughed, I was just crying my eyes out, recording, taking snapshots so I could show you later.
Well, something I didn't get to do for the listeners last time was play a few clips from the show. So I want to do that on today's episode. I want to play a few clips for the audience of Midday Kentucky, me talking.
I hope you play my favorite.
We'll see. We'll see if
okay.
that's the case. So for those listening at home, this is my table talk segment. This is the very first segment that I did. And this is, keep in mind, we've been on the air maybe 60 seconds up to this point, and she just flat out asked a little bit about who I am and what I'm there, and she asked about off the cuff. So take a listen. Did I describe that perfectly?
I think that was a perfect description of the show.
That was the very first episode that I was on, so I'm going to give you one more clip to listen to. This is from, I believe, my second appearance on the show,
okay.
And I'm going to play kind of just the opening segment of this episode. And what I like about this segment is it is very much off the cuff, no pun intended. I picture this show, when I go in and do it, I just picture that I'm on the radio. It's just you can see me with a better camera. That's all I'm trying to do.
That would be the best way, too.
So you can see here, we have no idea what we're going to talk about right when we open the lens of the camera. And you can see where here I am being me talking about something totally random, and she goes with it. So take a listen to see what you think of it.
Midday Kentucky at 12:30. I am Amber Freeman.
And I'm Adam Banks, host of the radio program Off the Cuff on WLXU 93.9.
Adam, you're back.
I am back. Feeling good today, surprisingly, because I didn't really...
Did we scare you that much yesterday?
No, not at all. I had a great time yesterday. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm just saying I'm surprisingly feeling well because I didn't really get much sleep last night.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to the world of TV.
Yeah. Well, it really wasn't that. I just got lost into the world of YouTube.
Oh, well, that's even worse.
Watching videos. Do you ever do that? Do you ever get trapped in YouTube?
Not in YouTube, because I don't have the attention span of even being in TV. I can't watch videos on the computer. But other stuff, yes.
And it was interesting what I was watching, too.
This was going to ask.
It was, did you ever watch, back in the 90s, the old talk shows like Sally Jesse Raphael, Montel, Jeannie Jones, Jerry Springer?
Any day you, like, took off school, that was exciting, because then you're like...
Yeah, and you know, I actually went on one of those talk shows.
I did not know this.
I mean, I wasn't a guest. Let me just be clear with that. I was in the audience. It was the Jerry Springer Show back in 2007.
Okay.
I was just an audience member. But yeah, I miss TV like that.
Do you? Trash TV?
I do. I miss trash.
So, there I am, just me being me, started talking about talk shows from the 1990s. Sally, Jesse, Raphael, Montel. Those were good talk shows, though.
They were great talk shows. Ricky Lake, you missed the best one. You know Ricky was my favorite.
Did I not say Ricky?
You did not say Ricky Lake.
And that was one of my favorites.
That was the best.
But seriously, though, I swear, I've told Amber this, too, on Midday Kentucky. I said, this show would be so much greater if we could actually have a live studio audience in the studio. I'm talking like, let's just invite people from the community or from the state to come watch the show live. And let me walk around with a little microphone with cards in my hand. You know what I'm saying? You know when they had the microphone and they had the cards with their first name on there, and they walk around, they're like, today on the show. I mean, how cool. Like, I believe Kentucky would eat that up.
Oh, gosh, yes. And we don't have anything like that right now.
There's
really
nothing out there like that. I think that would be amazing to actually bring in a live studio audience. Let us participate with the audience. Let's let the audience talk crap to the guest. Because that's really the only place. That was the only safe place to do is to go in one of those talk shows. You could talk crap in the audience. You could talk crap to the audience, and you could talk crap to the guest if you were an audience member.
There's no way that I would ever be able to come. Because, you know, I would just heckle you for the fun of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You'd have to revoke my invite.
But ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you do get to check out more of Midday Kentucky. I had to take a little time off from the show because my semester is starting back next week, and I have to get the semester underway for school before I can be more involved with the show. But once school starts back, hopefully I'll be more involved with the show, so you can check out the show at 12:30 on ABC 36.
Yep.
Hopefully you do.
If you miss it, let me know. I record them all.
Do you really?
I do.
But you record it with your phone.
I can't help it. That's the only way I have.
You actually, no, like, she actually, folks, records the show with her cell phone. Like, she just points the cell phone at the TV.
No, he's acting like it's an easy thing. Like, I position myself, like, awkwardly on my couch to get the best angle. It's a whole production for me to record you.
Before we go to our next break, Amber, I have to ask you this question here. If you are in favor of this brand new reboot that they are putting out with this Disney streaming service of Home Alone.
No.
So, folks, there was a meeting last week. Disney CEO Bob Iger announced that the company plans to reboot the movie Home Alone, a franchise it scooped up after its $71.3 billion acquisition of 20th Century Fox for its upcoming streaming service, Disney Plus. So Disney Plus, as you know, is coming out with a new streaming service to rival Netflix and Hulu, and they're coming up with their own original content. So they are wanting to remake a lot of movies. Home Alone is one of those movies that they're going to remake. You can't touch classics.
No.
And Macaulay Culkin, he's in good spirits about it. You know, he's poked a little fun at it. He basically went to Instagram and posted a picture of with his belly pushed out. And he said, this is what a reboot of Home Alone would look like today.
Because he is Home Alone.
Yeah.
Like, when you think Home Alone, you think Macaulay Culkin.
And that's the thing. I hate it when people think that you can take magical movies and recreate them.
No. It had nothing to do with the content, but everything to do with the person who portrayed that character.
Everything. It had everything lined up perfectly. The stars perfectly aligned. The cast, the set, the music. Everything about that movie is what made that movie. So quit trying to recreate it.
And that was such a simple time. Like, I have to ask, what's your favorite scene from Home Alone? I hope it's the same as mine.
Ooh. My favorite scene. I like the second one better than the first
one. Well, let's go with the first one, though. Because if this happened in today's time, this would never happen in today's time, so.
My favorite Home Alone. There's so many good quotes from Home Alone. There's so many, like, good things. Like, Kevin, you're such a disease.
Okay, well, I'm thinking in particular of Kevin walking home from the grocery store, and all of a sudden the bags just fall out.
Yeah.
And all of his stuff goes flying. That would not happen today. People have reusable bags and things like that. That wouldn't happen. That nobody would find that funny in today's generation.
Oh, you see, okay. And that's interesting. Like, how are they going to remake Home Alone? Because with technology today, it's going to be really hard to leave your kid at home.
You can't leave your kid at home. You've got cameras all over the place. You've got security systems, legit, not just timed lights.
Yeah, so you got, if Kevin is left at home and his mom is at the airport, all she's got to do is send him a text and say, hey, I don't see you. Where are you at? And he's like, Mom, I'm home. And she can say, okay, stay right there. We're coming back to get you.
I mean, the whole basis of the movie was the storm. The storm is what caused it all. It knocked electricity out.
Yeah.
And Ma Bell had to come and fix the phones.
They will come up with a way to make it not exactly the same, but they'll come up with a way to where he'll be inattentionally left at home.
And there's no way. I mean, you said that part two was your favorite. There's no way you can get on the wrong plane now. There's absolutely no way.
Right, because of just the security,
and they scan your tickets, and if your ticket doesn't scan, get to the back of the line. We'll figure you out after everybody gets on. No way. Like, if he runs into somebody, like, they don't hold paper tickets anymore like that.
Right, and you got to think about Home Alone too. When Kevin actually got on the wrong plane to New York, that should have never happened because he lost his ticket in the shuffle of tickets, and they said, "Oh, don't worry, just go one." Yeah. But that was pre 9/11, so security was very lax. It was what, 1992, 1993,
and obviously people have not been to Chicago's airport lately because you ain't running. I don't care if the reindeer song is playing; you ain't running that fast.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, stick around. We got lots more coming at you live right after these words.
Hey, y'all. This is Donnie Bowling, songwriter from Pikeville, Kentucky.
It's flying by.
LXU 93.9 LPFM, Lexington Community Radio. It's cold.
All right, we gotta cover the shootings.
Okay.
Shump House is throwing the bricks is the best scene. That is the best scene. I forgot about that. Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Amber is also in the studio with me. It is my unfortunate duty to have to talk about this, but it happened twice in 1 week.
In 1 day. One day.
In 1 day.
In 1 day. And it's weird that we're so... I feel like it's happening so much that some people are becoming desensitized to it. So I appreciate that you said it was your unfortunate duty, because I feel like with ease of access to social media, people are becoming so desensitized to this problem.
So if you haven't guessed, we're talking about the mass shootings that occurred over the week. And let's talk about the El Paso, Texas shooting first. That happened in Walmart. And what gets me about this is... this is something that I believe I've even said on the show before, that it is not going to be surprising when somebody walks one day into a Walmart and opens fire, walks into a retail store. Now, think about this. You talk about hitting home. How often do you go to Walmart? How often are you going to Walmart to just pick up just the little small things, like maybe a toothbrush or some deodorant? You make just pointless trips to Walmart. So sometimes it's just you don't even think about going, because you go so often.
Yep.
And this guy who, this monster, I should say, not guy, this monster who did this, he preyed on Walmart because of the crowd.
Well, it was a particular demographic he was trying to reach. Yeah. He was trying to reach a particular demographic.
Yeah, and he knew because it was so crowded in Walmart because of the back-to-school shopping, he knew that he was going to be able to take out a lot of people. So the suspect identified as Patrick Cruises.
Cruces,
21 years old. He told investigators following his arrest that he allegedly set out to kill as many Mexicans as he could, according to authorities. On Monday, law enforcement officials told ABC News that Cruces? What's his name?
I don't even care to get his name right.
Yeah, let's just say the monster. The monster cased the Walmart, going inside on Saturday without any weapons, apparently to size up the clientele inside the store, which is about 5 miles from the U.S.-Mexico border. He was satisfied with what he saw. He saw around 1,000 to 3,000 people inside the store at the time he went in there. And he said that's when he knew he wanted to go back out, get his firearms, and come back in and start shooting. And that's exactly what he did. He returned into Walmart wearing protective earmuffs, safety glasses, and wielding a high-powered assault-style rifle, according to a video surveillance of him inside the store. Police officials said he allegedly started firing indiscriminately at victims before he even walked through the front door. The victims were among more than two dozen people wounded in the massacre that erupted at about 10:39 a.m. local time on Saturday inside the Walmart, including children and parents drawn back to school cells. What do you make of it?
Well, I think the biggest thing that got me was, you know, I read through about all of the victims. I feel like that's something that I do when, you know, when these things happen. When we covered the incident in Virginia Beach, you know, I made it a point to make sure that I went through and I learned about these people. And the thing that, I don't want to say it hurt my feelings the most, but, you know, there were some key people who got killed. You know, you had Javier Rodriguez. You know, this little boy was 15 years old, about to start his sophomore year of high school. We were just talking about the first day of school.
Yeah.
This little boy had that, you know, he had that energy inside of him. He's getting ready to go back to school.
Yeah.
He was going to buy his stuff to go to school.
Yeah.
And he gets gunned down for no reason.
Yeah, he gets gunned down for No reason. Go ahead.
You had David Johnson. He was 63, was there with his wife and his granddaughter because he was shopping for his granddaughter to go back to school. Little girl was 9 years old and watched her grandfather, you know, get taken out. And I that resonated with me because my grandparents raised me. So that could have very easily been me and my papa just trying to go get stuff for school.
I hate it that his main target was to kill people of a race that was not his own. He wanted to kill Hispanics. He wanted to kill Mexicans. That's what he said. He wanted to kill as many Mexican people as possible. It's ridiculous that we have monsters walking the earth like that. And it's sad that you really cannot be safe anywhere out in public. It's happening, and it's happened almost anywhere now you can think of. It's happened in movie theaters. It's happened in shopping malls. It's happened now,
at concerts, at your work. I mean, it's just happening everywhere.
And now it's happened at Walmart, the retail giant that everybody goes to. It's happened there. And the fact that it was all because of racial hate. He targeted people that he hated just because of the color of their skin. Are we really still dealing with people like that?
I don't understand. And I don't think that and I'm not trying to say by any means I'm mentally healthy because, you know, I'm an advocate for mental illness. I just don't think that anyone who, my papa, you say right in the head. You can't be right in the head and look at somebody and be like, I hate you because you're this. And I think that you deserve to die. I can't even kill a snake, let alone take another person's life. That's not my job.
Well, this guy killed people ranging from ages 2 to 82. The killer lived in Allen, Texas, approximately 600 miles from the Walmart, and he's being charged for capital murder, and he shows that he was unemployed from court records. He was unemployed for the last 5 months, and he has no prior...
That we know of.
Criminal record, and he is being held without bond and granted a public defender from the court. At least 8 of the 22 people killed were Mexican nationals, and 9 additional Mexicans were among those wounded. Very sad situation. And the other mass shooting that occurred was in Dayton, Ohio. You hear about that and you're like, wow, Walmart hits home because it's a place we go all the time. And then you hear about Dayton, Ohio, which is 2 hours up the road.
Yep.
So talk about hitting home. Look how close that was. So less than 13 hours before the El Paso shooting, this happened. It happened on August 4th at 1:05 a.m. Eyewitnesses reported that a man opened fire at the entrance of Ned Pepper's Bar in the downtown Oregon Historic District of Dayton. He used an AR-15 equipped with a 100-round drum magazine. He fired into crowds and fatally shot 9 people. 10 people were killed, including the perpetrator, and 14 others were injured by gunfire. The gunman was killed by police within 30 seconds of the first shot being fired.
Can we just point out that, unfortunately, one of the 9 people who lost their lives was his own flesh and blood. It was his sister.
So was that intentional?
You know, I don't know. I've read a couple of things online that, you know, I don't want to spread anything that has not been confirmed. But from what I'm gathering, it maybe.
Yeah, so they classmates of the killer who went to high school with him said that he was a troubled guy. He had hit lists of people that he wanted to kill. You know, when I think of that, that's scary. Because you never know who's out there who might have you on a hit list.
Exactly.
And you might have said one wrong thing to them out of the way, and they've put you on that hit list. Well, this guy, he had a hit list of people he wanted to kill that he went to high school with, so he was very troubled.
I just want to know, if people knew that he had a hit list, why was nobody speaking up and saying anything?
Not only did he have a hit list, he had a rape list. He had a list of people he wanted to sexually assault. And nobody said anything.
That's the problem. We have gotten to this point in this world that we just don't speak up. We think, oh, that's not my problem. Not my chair, not my problem. You know, that was from a little video I used to watch back in the day. Not my chair, not my problem. And we can't keep going at that rate.
Yeah.
Somebody's got to take that chair and somebody's got to stand up and say something. We've got to change. People want to talk about the rapture coming all the time. We don't need to worry about the rapture. We're going to kill each other. Right. I mean, like, I don't know. I don't understand.
It's very sad, and the fact that this happened, and we got to talk about doing something about these gun laws. We have to.
Is it really guns? Because my grandfather used to sleep with a sawed-off shotgun underneath his pillow, and my grandfather never opened fire on anybody.
Well, no, it's not the guns itself that's actually growing legs and walking into a store and killing people or doing anything like that. It's people using these guns. So what I mean is, it's who we let have these guns. Who are we letting own these guns? Now, in Kentucky, you know that now Matt Bevin has made it legal for everyone to be able to carry a firearm without a permit. So
yep.
You can freely carry a gun in the state of Kentucky. It's like the Wild Wild West. Regardless of any training, any classes, you can carry a gun. Now, I'm all about the Constitution. I'm all about our amendments and the amendment to bear arms. But the fact that you can just give somebody a gun in this state, anybody, without any proper training is a little absurd to me. I mean, somebody who don't even know how to turn a safety on or off, someone who's never shot a gun, you're just going to allow them to be able to carry it around and you say they're qualified to shoot it because of a right. Okay, yeah. It's okay to have the right to do something. Yeah, I am for having the right to be able to bear arms, but we need to be able to make sure they're going into the hands of people that aren't going to do these type of things. Now, that's hard to control. It's impossible to control because anybody can snap, but we can't just give them free will. Let's let them take classes. Let's let them learn from safety classes, how to shoot a gun. Not only that, mental illness is a huge, huge cause of this.
Well, my biggest thing about it is, and I don't know if you feel the same way about this, but don't you feel like we romanticize these people a little bit?
These killers?
Yeah. Like, look at Columbine. We romanticize that all to pieces.
Yeah.
And I think that needs to be the front runner. Now, I do agree with you on the gun law. My only caveat to that is that I wish that these concealed classes did not come with a hefty price.
Yeah.
This should be something, if we're going to allow everyone to have it, we should be able to offer free classes. Now, I do know that these people had to go through training themselves and they need to get their money's worth, but why can't we have a reimbursement program through the state, you know, where they are reimbursed for each person that successfully passes that class? You know, I wanted to renew my concealed carry because, you know, I have a firearm. But I was not going to pay.
So you took the classes.
Back in the day, back home, I did take the classes. I was about 18. My grandfather made me.
Yeah.
But I didn't pay for it back then. And then when I was kind of investigating, like, oh, I probably should get mine concealed because, you know, it has expired. It was like $75 to $150. Well, that's almost just as much as I paid for my gun. Like, I'm not going to pay that.
Well, in Kentucky, that bill went into effect Thursday, June the 27th. So it was right in the middle of summer. Senate Bill 150. Is what they called it, passed by the legislature, and it was signed by Governor Matt Bevin, making Kentucky the 16th state with a permitless concealed carry law. The measure allows gun owners 21 years or older to carry a concealed weapon without a background check, permit, or safety training.
Whoa, no background check?
No background check. Kentucky's previous concealed carry law required 6 hours of safety training, a background check, and a $60 application fee to obtain permit. So no, you don't need a background check anymore in this state. You don't need anything to carry a gun anymore.
So how are we going to control that we have, you know, convicted felons who have had that, you know, constitutional right taken away from them? How are we going to control that they're not accessing these?
It says those carrying must still meet other laws for legal gun ownership. For example, convicted felons still may not possess a firearm.
Yeah, but if you're not doing a background check on me, how are you supposed to know I'm a convicted felon?
True. The law also does not change where people can have... the law also does not change where people can have their weapons. I guess it's talking about you just can't give weapons away. You got to legally buy them.
I mean, I understand, like, transferring serial numbers, so if, you know, you sell me a gun and I go out and shoot somebody with it, it's not going to come back to you. But I was not aware that we were no longer doing background checks.
Yeah, and so, but that allows you to freely own the gun, carry it around in the state. But if you go outside of the state, you have to follow by their law. So you just can't carry from Kentucky to a state that doesn't allow it. But, yeah, it's...
Well, I mean, a lot of people have had guns for a long time. You know, you could carry a firearm in your vehicle. You just had to make two motions to get to it.
Yep.
You know, you couldn't just have it laying, you know, over in your seat, you know, loaded. You could not do that. You had to have two motions to get to it. So, in a sense, I see why people are like, oh, it's not any different from that. I get that argument, but no background checks?
Yeah.
No background checks.
Well, and plus a mental health check, too. There's these people who go into places like Walmart and kills thousands or hundreds of and hundreds of people.
And have rape lists and hitman lists.
They are not mentally sane. Something is wrong with them. And if you have a mental illness, and I'm talking about a serious mental illness, you should not be able to carry.
I mean, I do have a serious mental illness. I have, and I've had it since, you know, I want to say I was 9, 10 years old. But I am controlled. You know that. You've personally seen. I am medicated for my illness. And I do snap. I snap, but my snapping is not going and grabbing my gun. I think that there are other things that need to be taken into consideration, because severe depression and severe anxiety, which is what I have, is considered a major mental illness.
Well, when I say, I'm not trying to undermine it and say that it's not a serious issue. I guess the best way to word it is if someone is a
paranoid schizophrenic, I understand where you're going.
You see what I'm saying. When it's something that, not discrediting your mental illness, saying that it's not serious, but when you have something on that level, when you have somebody on the level of...
When you have issues with paranoia and and when you can be considered a danger to yourself, I do think that we should have a line drawn.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take our last commercial break, and we will be right back after these words.
Lexington Community Radio is proud to have the support of Founding Community Partner and State Farm Agent Deborah Hensley. Deborah believes in giving every member of our community a chance to let their voice be heard to unify strength in our city. To learn more, you can visit
wobbly wobbly mind.
276-3242.
What did you just do?
It sucks because I can't, like...
You know what we're not going to get to?
I've got a song that you're going to like.
Staying up to date before, during, and after emergencies. The Be Ready Lexington app from Lexington.
Because you know I'm going to grill you on number 9. I want you to explain.
Don't get me in trouble.
I won't. I know.
As soon as you install it, you'll have all the information you need to be prepared right in your
face. What's wrong with my headphones?
I think we were just aggravated because we were already having other issues. That's probably all it was.
For whatever reason, I feel like I've been wanting you all my life.
Welcome back, everybody, to Off the Cuff. Adam Banks here with you. Amber is also in the studio with me, and I told her, I said, I want to play this song for you. This song is for you, this intro music, because you love Britney Spears.
I love Britney Spears. I appreciate that.
Yeah, and I said, Amber probably isn't a fan of the music that I play on this show a lot of the times, so I said, I'm going to do one her a solid. I'm going to play Britney Spears.
I dig it.
So there you go.
I dig it.
Do you like this song?
Not my favorite, but you know what? I'll take any Britney. I don't discriminate with Britney.
Big part of our childhood, Britney Spears, was... Amber, speaking of being a child, we're now adults.
Old.
We're now old. We're in our 30s. And one of the things that reminds us that we are old is sometimes we can tell we have aged by the purchases that we make. You know, sometimes you go out and you make a very adult purchase. And you know what I'm talking about. Purchases like... When you get excited over buying something like a shower head or a new pillow.
I was going to say, I just bought new pillows.
Or a new bed, or a new thing of sheets for your bed.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, when you buy something like that, that's a very adult purchase, and sometimes you get very excited over it when you buy stuff like that. So, the other day, I went out and bought a vacuum cleaner.
Okay.
Very excited over that. Little dirt devil.
Oh, you're a little dirt devil.
So, it's my little dirt devil. Takes up the dirt. Just like...
Well, you know, I actually just bought a new vacuum cleaner, too.
Yeah.
Well, you should have asked me. I would have told you about mine.
And you really realize that you're getting old when you get excited about making purchases.
Oh,
like
and
that.
Mine's got a detachable arm, and I think that was when I knew that was the best thing that ever happened to me, was it had a detachable arm. I didn't have to bend down anymore.
What do you use that arm for, though?
The stairs, and, you know, I've got corgis, and there's hair everywhere, so I can get in all the corners. And
well, I bought a vacuum cleaner because...
Did you not have a vacuum cleaner before that?
It broke. It went bad. So, you know that I have to have everything in place. I'm a very clean person.
I know.
My house, correct me if I'm wrong, it's very spotless.
You could eat off the floor.
Yes, I just like to keep things very clean. Have you ever been in a nasty house?
I love my granny and my pa, but yeah, I grew up in a nasty house.
Okay, so please don't take no offense to
this. No, I don't.
Please take no offense to this when I say this, but I don't understand how people can live in pure filth willingly. You don't have to have a lot of money to be clean. You don't have to be rich to have a clean house. You can be poor, and you can be broke and not have anything, a dime to your name, but there is no reason to live in filth. I have went into a lot of homes, more often than I have liked to admit, but I have went into a lot of homes to where I have literally, Amber, I have literally gagged from the smell of their house.
Oh, like, but how did you keep your composure? Like, I think that's the biggest question I have is how do you keep, because I know when I experience things like that, you know I'm very animated, and you're very animated just as I am. How did you keep calm?
I mean, there's something, like, you don't want people to see that you're gagging, but you can't help it. Like, I remember walking into this very, very particular house that was just, it was nasty. It just had the smell to it. You could walk by the door and just get a whiff of the air in the house, and it would make you gag. And I remember going to this house. It was people that I knew, but I had no idea that they lived like this because they went out in public very clean. And
yeah,
their car was decent. It didn't stink or anything. So I just assumed that their house was okay. And then when I went into their house, I gagged, like, of the smell, the stench. And I was like, I wouldn't let my dog live in this house. It was that nasty. I don't understand how people can live in pure filth. I mean, there was pizza stuck on the walls.
Oh.
There was just cat hair, dog hair, mouse hair, snake skin, just all kinds of things that was just...
Did you just describe my house?
No. But I don't understand how people can just live in nastiness. I think there's something...
Well, I think there's different levels of nastiness. Like, I feel like at my house, I'm clean dirty. Do you agree? I'm clean dirty.
Yeah, and I'm not talking about you when
he's
I'm talking
about
this.
He's talking about
I'm not venting about your house.
But, okay, so
your house doesn't make me gag when I walk in.
I hope not, because
no.
You're there.
That's when you know your house is really bad, is when literally you have visitors and you look over them and they're trying not to, like... Like, I would try to hold back like that I was gagging, but I couldn't.
Well, okay, so on a scale of 1 being your apartment, 10 being, you know, the city dump, or I guess the city landfill, where would you rate this house?
I would... say that again now?
So on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being your house,
yeah,
10 being the city landfill,
yeah,
where would you rate this house?
this was in the dump, like at the dumpster.
Is it like the next level dump? Like, are we talking like it's like a 12-13, like New York landfill?
It's, yeah.
Okay.
Like one of the worst I was ever at.
Gross.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't feel comfortable sitting down there.
How'd you get yourself out? This is just pure curiosity. How did you get yourself out of the situation then?
Well, so the people that own the house, they were like, do you want to have a seat? You know, do you want to sit down? And I'm like, no, that's okay. I've been standing all day. I use that little excuse.
Yeah.
I sit a lot at my job, which I don't. But I just had to say something,
yeah,
to excuse, you know, me not sitting there. And people are writing me and texting me right now, asking me if I'm talking about their house. I'm not talking about, this is nobody that I know, that I'm close to. So put your mind at ease. I'm not talking about anybody's house like
He's
that.
He's talking about me, guys. There you go.
I probably couldn't be friends with you if you had that nasty of a house. Because I will never go back around these people again because I just can't stand pure filth. There is no sense in it.
Okay, but, well, I'm still curious. How did you get yourself out of the situation?
Well, I just... There's really nothing you can do. You just say you gotta go, leave. There's nothing you do to get yourself out of a situation except just leave the scene. Leave the scene of the crime. It was... But there is different levels of nastiness. You have hoarders... People who hoarder. I don't necessarily think that's nasty. That's just people who like to collect things, and sometimes it can appear nasty. And sometimes I get it. An older house might appear nasty because it's just a lot of things in the house is old looking.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not like it's nasty, it's just old. But I'm just talking about pure, genuine filth. Where they
so, like, we're talking like heaping trash, dishes ain't been done in weeks.
Maybe a tampon laying there just for everybody to see on the kitchen table. Yeah, things like that.
Like a used tampon?
Used one. I'm talking pure, 100% filth. I'm talking, I went into this house and it was 100% filth.
Okay, well, whoever keeps used tampons on your countertop, he is talking about you. Because that's a pretty specific thing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for listening to another episode of Off the Cuff. It's always a pleasure to have you. You can check out all of our previous episodes on iTunes. You can check us out also on YouTube or Spotify. Follow Off the Cuff's Facebook page at Off the Cuff with Adam Banks. You can follow me on Instagram at AdamBanks818. Follow me on Twitter at AdamBanks88. You can follow Amber at Ambu447 with Twitter and Snapchat.
I don't do Twitter.
Instagram and Snapchat is what you do.
And guys, don't forget, we are still, once we hit 1,000 people on Off the Cuff with Adam Banks Facebook page, I am going to drench him in ice cold water.
I was hoping people forgot about that.
I will never forget about that.
And I'm starting to see the page growing in numbers.
Oh, I am too.
I'm like, oh God. In a way, I'm very excited for it. But then in a way, I'm like, ooh, once it gets to 1,000.
Because you know.
There's got to be a cutoff date with this, though. If we don't get... No, you can't just come at me 10 years from now and say, okay, we got 1,000 views, time to dash you in cold water. No, we got to have a cutoff date. We have to have 1,000...
If by December 2019 we don't have 1,000, then we'll come up with a new one.
I'll come up with a new one,
We'll come up with a
Maybe
new one.
Maybe Amber gets drenched in water.
Nobody wants to see that.
Oh, you'd be surprised. You'd be surprised. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as always, it's a pleasure to have you listening. That is Amber Turner. I'm Adam Banks. This is Off the Cuff. We will see you next Thursday from 4 to 5 right here on WLXU 93.9 FM. Have a great week. Keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping. Hey, Dad. Mental health needs to be better addressed. I agree. To the future.
All right.
So, Amber? And look, we kind of match today.
We do.
That's when you know you've been hanging out way too long between the match. All right, everybody, thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the next episode.